So hey there, my name is Brent Smith and I'm the common constitutionalist. And again, I look at disaster because I am so freaking tired. I've basically been at my office all day, stripping and painting, pressure washing and everything else, and making some headway, but man, a Manischewitz, it's I'm freaking tired. But again, I'm not gonna let this stop me. I'm here and I'm doing my video podcast. I'm gonna stick to my notes and I'm gonna get through this. If I nod off in the middle of this thing, I'm not a narcoleptic, I'm just exhausted. So anyway, we're gonna talk about a couple of topics today. I entitled this podcast, the first segment is California Cops Run Out of Juice. That's a classic. And taking the ham out of hamburger. There you go. So that's what I'll be discussing today, if I can get through this, on the Common Constitutionalist Weekend Video Podcast. I'll be right back. Yeah.
You're watching the Common Constitutionalist Weekend Video Podcast.
So, let me pose a question to you. So what's more important, do you think? Is it catching bad guys or fighting the apocalyptic scourge of global warming? So maybe that was too general a question. So maybe I'll narrow the parameters just a little bit. So, okay. Say if you're a police department, what's more important? See, that's a little more specific. Paint all over my hands. Yeah, buddy. Catching bad guys for the police, is it catching bad guys or fighting the apocalyptic scourge of global warming? If you said catching the bad guys, you win. Well, nothing but my undying appreciation that you're smarter than the average liberal, whatever. But if you said fighting global warming, you've probably already been a victim of a crime, and that's basically someone stole your brain. Just saying. And speaking of global warming, crime, and having no brains, this is from The Blaze. I found this on The Blaze. Unbelievable. California police officer, this is the title of the article. California police officer forced to abandon chase after Tesla patrol vehicle runs low on battery. What a shocker, and it's happening in California. I'm stunned that it's in California. Apparently the department is trying to get out is trying out electric cars as part of a push to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, because that's such a prevalent thing in the police department, you know. That's a big freaking deal, I guess, right? Of course, in California, all this nonsense is a big freaking deal. A Tesla electric patrol car fizzled out on an officer in the middle of a police chase in Fremont, California last week when a low battery caused the officer to drop his pursuit. Can you believe this? But that's a rhetorical question, because this is California, and nothing is too lunacy, it's too loony for California. Nothing is too stupid for Californians to try, or at least the people in charge anyway. And then you people in California, you can't bitch because you're the people who put these people in office. So that's enough of that. And another thing, stop moving out of California to other states and bringing your wacky liberalism and your leftism to other states and turning them purple and blue. So stay in California. We should wall your asses off. Excuse my French. So what are the details on this thing? This is a direct quote from the officer. I am down to 6 miles. I'm down to 6 miles of battery on the Tesla, so I may lose it here in a sec, unquote. The officer can be heard telling dispatch, according to police radio transmissions obtained by KPIX-TV. Quote, if someone else is able, can they maneuver into the number one spot, unquote? Other patrol officers were able to jump in and continue chase on the subject, but ultimately, now listen to this, ultimately abandoned their pursuit after the situation became dangerous when the suspect began driving erratically. He's a freaking crook, apparently, or a suspected crook, all right, the suspect. He's a crook. Of course he's going to drive erratically. He doesn't want to be caught. Duh. So, there you go. So they, I don't know what he was supposed to have done, because that's not part of the story. CNN reported that the suspect's car was later found abandoned in San Jose, California. Whoop-de-doo. I don't know where Fremont and San Jose are. Who cares? It's California. Don't care. A spokesman explained to KPXI, quote, the Tesla wasn't... Now dig this. Dig this. Quote, the Tesla wasn't fully charged at the beginning of the shift. This unfortunately happens from time to time. Here's the excuse. Even in our other vehicles that run on gas, if they're not refueled at the end of the shift, unquote. And yes, I'm sure, like I said, I'm sure it happens from time to time to all vehicles. But how come I've never heard of this, someone running out of gas in the middle of a high-speed chase? Have you ever heard that? I've never heard it. I'm sure it's happened, but I've never heard it. As a matter of fact, I was thinking as I was going through this article, I've never heard one time where anyone has ever recorded a call or had a call released, dispatch call, that I'm running out of gas and I have to suspend my chase, or can somebody take over because I'm almost out of gas. Never heard that. So the reason why, more often than not, I would say, is that what happens when you start your shift as a police officer? You get in the car and you probably check the gas gauge. First thing you do, everybody looks at the gas gauge on their way out. You look at the gas gauge. And what do? If it's low, you stop by the station or to stop by the designated area, you fill up and you get on your way. Because you're in a patrol car. And what's a patrol car do? It drives around the city, or it drives around the county, or it does whatever. It doesn't just sit in one spot and with the battery off and wait for some perp to drive by and then give chase. All right, the Tesla has, I think, 260 mile range or something like that. And that's if you drive it modestly or moderately. If you really stand on this thing, just like gas, when you really step on the gas, you get less miles per gallon. When you step on the gas, so to speak, more electricity has to be generated to push that car faster, which means that you're going to run out of battery faster. Now, there's a difference between the stupid freaking Teslas and a cop car and a gas-powered cop car. A gas-powered cop car, you literally can stop anywhere and fill up. In a Tesla, sure, you can. The nice thing about a Tesla is you could plug it into any wall socket. And then if you want to come back 4 days later, it'll be 100% charged in a 110-volt wall socket. It takes 4 days to charge a Tesla in a 110-volt socket, just a regular house outlet. Now, you can go to a super Tesla charging station, of which I'm sure there's thousands of them around California. Not. I get there, I bet there's, I don't know how many there are, but I bet there's very few. And it'll only take you 70 minutes to charge it to 100% charge. 70 minutes. Okay? So you get in your car, you see that it's low on battery at the beginning of your shift, and it takes you an hour and a half out of your day just to charge the stupid thing up because somebody didn't charge it the night before, or it could take you about 7 minutes to fill up your car with gas. So this is just a total crock of crap, and it makes absolutely no sense that they would use electric vehicles for police patrol vehicles. Okay? I suppose if you're going to start from word go, if you're in a Tesla and it's fully charged and you're parked and it's taking no power at all, and then somebody speeds by you, you could give chase and you could probably catch them before you run out of battery. But if you're driving around the city all day, and at the very end of your shift, when the battery's at 6 miles to go until it's completely dead, and then somebody decides to take off? Well, geez, that's bloody inconvenient now, isn't it? It's just the dumbest thing I've ever heard. It should be a complete joke, but these people in California are deadly serious about this nonsense that they care more about global warming than public safety. Jeez, just incredible. So that's enough of that. I just thought that was completely absurd, and I thought that I could bring it to my viewers' attention how absurd this is, and of course, only in California. Of course, you can't really say that anymore, but whatever. I'll be right back.
You're watching the Common Constitutionalist Video Podcast.
Yeah, baby! Yeah.
Okay, I'm back. I still got several Saturdays left of this stuff to go. So, and that's another reason why, if you've noticed, on my website, on my Common Constitutionalist website, there hasn't been as much original content lately because I've been doing all this stuff on the weekends, and I'm also a volunteer dog walker at the local animal shelter. I started that last spring, I think, on the weekends, and so that takes my Sundays, and so I'm having to download and do a lot of other stuff during the week, which I used to be able to do on the weekends so I could write more articles. So I apologize for not having more original content, but that's the reason why. It's because I'm doing this stuff and I'm doing the doggy walking. I'm not gonna give up the doggy walking. That is just, it's wonderful. If you have an opportunity to volunteer at an animal shelter, either for cats or dogs or whatever, do it. You get more out of it than the dogs do, and believe you me, the dogs get plenty out of it. They love to see us. They just love it. Sunday mornings, it's the best, baby. Anyway, okay, so we're taking the ham out of we're taking the ham out of Hamburger, baby, and you'll love to know the reason why. Burger King. This is from South Africa. Yes, indeed. Not exactly across the street. What the heck do I got all over me? Paint, probably. So Burger King in South Africa is dropping the name Hamburger from its menu, because the word ham, dig this, might offend who? Muslims. That's right. The word ham and hamburger might offend Muslims. Are you freaking kidding me? No, they're not kidding us. But this is just, of course, it's just starting in South Africa. It'll go. It'll drift through, whatever. And this is the only, so far, Burger King's the only one doing this. So, unless you are a complete 100% grade A moron, you know that there is not a gram's worth of ham in hamburger. That's not where hamburger came from. Hamburger was named after the city of Hamburg, Germany, and it was derived from a ground beef mixture called Hamburg steak. Hamburger. Dig? Okay? There's no ham in hamburger. But the mere word offends Muslims. Yes, indeed. But then again, hey, where did they learn that? Probably from United States and European liberals, because they're offended by literally everything. So why not follow their lead? So I wonder then, if the word ham offends them so, how many Muslims live in Hamburg, Germany? In Hamburg, Germany. There's about 4 to 6 million Muslims that live in Germany. And I think the estimate is between 100 to 150,000 live in Hamburg. Aren't they offended even to live in the city of Hamburg? Why are they living there in the first place? I know why they're living there in the first place. Because Germany, like the United States, has great giveaways. Okay? They have a wonderful welfare system. All you got to do, according to Angela Merkel, is just get there. Okay? Like Gavin Newsom in California. Well, or just anywhere in the United States. Just get here and you can stay. Yay. So anyway, why don't they move out of Hamburg if it's so offensive? I don't know. So let's get a little more absurd, shall we? Let's demonstrate absurdity by being absurd about the word ham or pork. Okay? In the Korean War, there was the Battle of Pork Chop Hill. See? Absurd. Okay? Demonstrating absurdity by being absurd. The Battle of Pork Chop Hill during the Korean War. It was fought between troops of U.S., Thailand, Colombia, the Republic of Korea, North Korea, and China, okay? So there must have at least been some Muslims fighting on Pork Chop Hill. Did they get a special dispensation or something? Were they allowed not to fight because it was called Pork Chop Hill? I mean, again, I obviously I'm being funny and I'm being facetious about this, but that's how absurd this is. Taking the ham away from hamburger when everybody knows there's no ham in freaking hamburger. It's just ridiculous. But again, Pork Chop Hill. There was Hamburger Hill, I think, in Vietnam, wasn't there? Battle of Hamburger Hill? Or was that just a movie? I don't know. Whatever. So, and so I'd like to say that this is one of the stupidest things I've ever heard, but when you wake up tomorrow, you'll hear something even more dumb, and so that'll be the stupidest thing you've ever heard, and on and on and on. So you can't ever actually even say that anymore, because every day you wake up, liberals and leftists are being dumber than they were yesterday, the previous day. So this is from this is the actual write-up from the Cape Town News. Actually, it's called Cape Town, etc. Burger King drops the ham and hamburger. Many, and it's actually, well, you'll see, because it's not quite as bad as we think. Many locals have been scratching their heads over Burger King's latest announcement that several stores. Now look at this. This is like oxymoronic, or I don't know how to describe this thing. The latest announcement that several of their stores are now going to be serving bacon and therefore losing their halal certification. So some of the Burger Kings are dropping the word ham from hamburger, yet they're going to so which is offensive to the Muslims, but then they're going to start serving bacon on their burgers, okay? So they're going to call it the Bacon King, and out of respect for Muslims, however, they will be dropping the ham from the menu. So they're going to be dropping the name ham, but they're going to be actually serving bacon. That's terrific. And they're losing their halal certification. And I guess the Burger Kings in South Africa don't give a flying crap if they have halal certification. And don't even get me started on freaking halal certification, because it's just a front for terrorism. Okay, that's what they do. At least in the United States with ISNA and all these other people, they're involved in certification for halal throughout restaurants and food service and whatnot. And they give a portion of every certification, because you have to pay a fee to be certified halal, just like you know a kosher thing, except kosher isn't terrorism, okay? The halal certification, never mind the barbaric way they have to kill the animals and all that stuff. And I don't know that they still do that, but that's the traditional way. It's gruesome as crap. But that's not what I mean. Halal certification in America, it has been proven that a portion of that certification fee goes to Hamas and Hezbollah and things like that for terrorism overseas and possibly the United States. So that's why one of my favorite chicken restaurants in the city that I live became halal certified. I've never darkened the door since, and I won't. Period. I'm just not going to, because I know the background of halal certification. Okay, I know what a gruesome thing it is as far as the meats go, and even worse, the fact that a portion of the fee, the money spent by the companies to certify stuff halal, goes to terrorism. So don't, you know, I don't want to hear anything beyond that. Okay. So the news comes as the fast food giant has decided to add bacon to their menu, introducing a new Bacon King. They don't say hamburger, a towering burger featuring a heaping helping of crispy bacon. But there's a consequence, and it's serious. Oh, sure it is. As of this month, a select number of their stores no longer have the halal certification. In spite of this, the menu will still feature original halal menu items. So they've dropped their certification, but if you're a Muslim, you can still go eat at Burger King and get your halal menu item. Unless you're too offended to go in and smell the bacon cooking. Man, I'm gonna have some bacon when I get home. I can't stand it. So Burger King says it has this move was inspired by a number of requests from listen to this now. We could take a page out of South Africa. Burger King, now listen. Burger King says they're actually gonna listen to their customers. What a novelty. Burger King in South Africa says this move was inspired by a number of requests from non-halal consumers for a new offering that includes bacon. Imagine that. A restaurant which actually caters to and listens to their actual customers instead of here in frickin' America where the pansy corporations kowtow to a bunch of Twitter mobs or two or three people who whine and bitch on Twitter or Facebook or something like that, and then the CEOs or the board of the board of the corporation, whatever it happens to be, panics, oh, we can't do this, we gotta do, you know, something, but the transgender thing, and it's just, it's all the same crap. These guys, they're actually listening to their customers. Go figure. So in a total of 40 restaurants across the country will lose their certification, with 56 remaining unchanged. Forming part of this movement, Burger King will also be removing the ham out of respect for Muslim patrons. From now on, they'll just be called burgers. So I had some more on that, but I think we get the idea. So kudos, frankly, to Burger King that they're actually listening to their own consumers rather than the dopey Twitter mobs and the identity politicians and whatnot that say, you know, you have to have transgender bathrooms for, you know, 0.75% of the American public. And that's what rules the day instead of their own consumers. If you pulled, say for example, Target, if you pulled the customers, 99.9% of the customers that go into Target, particularly if they're families, will say no transgender bathrooms. We don't want stinky old hairy 40-year-old men dressing with my 8 and 10-year-old girl, my 14-year-old girl in the dressing room. We've already heard many instances of that kind of stuff, but again, they're kowtowing to the Twitter mob and they're kowtowing to liberalism and leftism rather than their own consumer base. So it's the same reason why I won't darken the door at Walmart, because they stopped selling ammunition, they stopped selling rifles, and it's ridiculous. It's absolutely ridiculous that they kowtow to these leftists and they're hurting their own business model. So I've got Kmart, I guess, is the only place that I can go. Thankfully, there's online because I buy almost everything online and just have it shipped to me. But if I need to go into a store, I'm severely limited right now because I'm not going into a Target and I'm not going to a Walmart anymore. But other than that, kudos to Burger King for listening to their customers. Pretty funny that they're taking the ham out of hamburger, but they're actually putting bacon on the menu, baby. Yes. So that's all I've got. My name is the Exhausted Common Constitutionalist. I'm going to go home and probably sleep. Probably actually not. I'll probably watch some college football and just be a zombie for a while or something like that. But at any rate, y'all have a blessed balance of the weekend. That's about all I got. See you next week.